Good afternoon to all. Am I audible to you?
Yes, sir.
Any queries from the last week's session regarding the jQuery and Ajax? We just started to understand about these two important features, jQuery and Ajax. Any queries, any doubts regarding those two topics? Yep. Any queries? So just to have a quick a recap of the last weeks, so we'll have some kind of discussion in just recollecting the last week's topic. So we'll start with jQuery. So what is this jQuery is about? Can anybody please respond? What is the use of a jQuery, or why this technology is required for us? Am I audible to you, please? Yes, please. At least you can start reading this material now quickly. Introduction to jQuery. Am I audible to you?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yeah, please let us have some quick discussion. So what is jQuery?
It's a library.
Okay, it is a library. Fine. A library for what?
To do more, and by writing less and we do more.
Yeah, write less, do more. So this library has got a lot of functions, a lot of methods, lot of capabilities. You can write less number of programming instructions, less number of in other terms, less code lines, and you can do more. You can extract more functionality, and you can do more application developments. The application features can be realized with the writing less number of lines of code. So this writing less number of lines of the code are related to what language, or what is the basic background of jQuery? jQuery, J stands for
JavaScript.
So basically, yeah, somebody, Sachin, tell me.
So it has inbuilt functions which we can use for animations and.
So this jQuery, a library, has got inbuilt functions. When you say library itself, that library has got so much of functionalities for us to use it in our web applications, in designing and developing our web pages and web applications and web resources. So what is the importance of jQuery here? Of course, you already mentioned this write less and do more. That statement is very easy to say, but to technically talk about, what is this jQuery is trying to do? Yes, please. In what way we are going to use this jQuery? That you please try to express a little bit.
So we calling events or something. JQuery.
We are calling some events. Okay. Okay, Tawab. We are to be more precise and to be more clear. We are using this jQuery statements to basically manage our dash objects. Can you fill in this blank, please?
We are using document.
HTML?
Documents.
Yeah, of course. HTML documents, your web documents only. Sorry?
DOM object.
Yeah, DOM objects. Very good. So we use this jQuery to easily in the sense that is very flexible in handling the DOM objects of the web pages. So what is a DOM object again? What is a DOM? Again, I'm going back to some time back, almost 4 or 5 weeks back. What is a DOM? D-O-M.
A document object model.
Yes, what is the what is that document object model is going to do?
For using that, we can interact with the HTMLs. Website.
Yeah, the document object model is basically a tree structure, a hierarchical structure which help us to manage our web elements easily, manage, manipulate, process our web elements easily. So the DOM structure will always enable the developer or the web developer or the web programmer to use the web elements in a more efficient and a more effective manner because of this dynamic nature of our web pages and web resources. So to use those DOM objects properly, we can make use of this jQuery, the library functions. So a combination of jQuery with your DOM objects is going to be very much useful for you to handle very complex websites, complex web applications, which needs some kind of a very complex application in the sense that a big application which involves so many other web elements in the web pages, so many web components which are required, which have to be played in a real time, which have to be accessed in a real time and all, so on and so forth. We require so much of functionalities. So for that, to develop a web page to handle that complex application, we can make use of this jQuery very easily to handle the DOM objects in a real time, so that it will be easy for us to access the data across the net. So this, you can go through these slides. Please go through that. I think you are not reading the last week's discussions. So please go through the slides again. So I have given you the brief introduction about jQuery. So please go through it once. If you have any queries, please let me know. We have done some small exercises too for this, if you remember the last week's class. So again, little bit more number of features. That's what we have not yet completed the jQuery. See, it is goes on for another 1 or 2 weeks also, it goes on with jQuery. So I put some more features for you to understand and practice it. So today we will be going through jQuery as well as Ajax, what we started in the last week, with some more features. So we'll see what are those features are. The material is available on the course page. I hope you are able to access the material. Are you able to access the material?
Yes, sir.
jQuery more features, yes, here. Okay. Yeah, let me just open the material and I will. We'll go through example wise in this material and some exercises too. So let me go through it. So usually we write the statements of the jQuery always is preceded with a dollar symbol. Please remember. So dollar followed by open brace. So within the open brace, you write document. So what is this document is referring to? Please, anybody can tell me from the last week's discussion.
Current document. That is being
current document, yeah, current web
current
page
context.
don't say context, the current web page only. It is the web page which you are seeing. See, at present I am seeing this web page. So this is an email inbox. So another web page is this. So if I am referring to this web page, it is a current document. So I'm at present I'm referring to this document itself in this web page. So it is referring to this. So what does this dot ready indicates? So this function name is dollar document dot ready. Ready is also a function. So what does this ready function is indicating, or what is it conveying to us? Of course, the description I have given here before, but last week's point of discussion, I would like to know what is you have understood.
Sir, your screen is not visible.
Oh, sorry. I am presenting it, right?
It's visible.
It's blank.
Visible.
Yeah, I am. For me, the option is you are presenting. That's what it shows. What about now? What you are able to see now? Can you please, anyone can tell me?
We can see the document not ready.
Ah. Tawab, are you unable to see the document?
Yes, sir. Yes. Yes.
Are you able to see the document?
Yes, sir. Yes, I'm able.
Yeah, so who is having difficulty? Can you please tell me?
Yeah, now it's visible, sir. I was
Oh, Sachin, okay. Yeah. Okay, so here dollar document.ready function is this is a jQuery statement. You are going to write the statement. You can see in the example here. So it always tells that once you open a web page on the browser, so once the web page is rendered on the browser, once the web page is displayed, once the web page is ready. See, all means the same. All the sentences, when I say web page is ready, web page is rendered on the browser. Rendered means it is displayed on the using the browser. A web page is ready. A web document is been shown. So all these things implies that the web page is now ready to use it. So you can say the dot ready function. So in shorthand, you need not say function here. So you can just simply say a ready. So that in short, you can see these two examples also we have seen in the last class. So for short, you can write just simply say document dollar document dot ready. It always implies that it is a function which implies that ready function is implying that the web page is ready to be displayed, and it is displayed on the browser. So that function is basically anonymous. Nobody is calling that function. The function is getting run, executed. So whenever the function, see function ready function, you can write it. What is the ready function? If you want to write something else, when the function ready function is getting executed, you can write the corresponding ready function separately, the definition of the ready function, and you can pass it on as an argument to the ready function itself. So you write the definition of the ready function and you pass it on as a parameter to the ready function. It will execute whatever the definition you are trying to specify. So by default, when you are using this jQuery statement, this ready function will not be having any arguments. But if you are specifying some logic that it needs to do something else when the web page is ready and the web page is displayed on the browser, you need to specify that logic by writing some function name inside that ready, and you are going to define that function outside this particular dollar document. So this one small examples we have seen it. Now let us see in the last class also we have seen how do you select the elements from the web page. Selecting the elements means how do you access the elements. Can anybody tell me how did we access the elements? What are the various ways of accessing the elements, that is the DOM elements, the document object model elements, or the objects of a web page? How did we access? What are the various ways?
Class ID.
Yes, you by using element by, you might have seen get element by ID, class ID, tag ID, selector IDs. So these are all the different. Sorry, please tell me. Yeah.
By using name also.
Yeah, by using the name ID name itself, right? So even that material I have given to you, you can just use this, the same example, dollar my ID. You can see this is, what is this hash my ID? Hash implies what?
ID.
The ID, always see, whenever you access the elements, whenever you select the elements, see the material already, it is given in the slides. That's why I have given you with a little bit write up in this material, so that you need not refer back to some other materials. This material is sufficient for you if you see in the PPTs that I have given in the last week. So a little bit of description also is given here. So here, where element dollar hash my ID, dollar hash my ID with the paragraph selecting a particular group of elements or a particular element of your web page. So selecting a particular division of your web page. Like this, these examples may have not given you certain descriptions. So, but in this material, the one which I have given to you now, so you will see a little bit of description also that will be helpful for you to understand and go about with different examples. So hopefully this will be a little bit helpful for you. Of course I collected from the Google only, from various web sources. So you can use the same examples too. So whenever you are accessing some elements of your web page, you can access by using your elements by ID, or you can use it by your class names, or by using your attribute names of a particular ID. The attribute name here is the first name, or by using the CSS selector, the compound unordered list. So this what does the hash content implies for anyone, please? Hash contents of your web page, which particular element is it referring to, or what is this hash content means? For your DOM object, what is this hash content? Anyone, have you understood the question first? Hello.
The yes, value which the ID content.
Which ID I am referring to here? Did I mention any ID here? I have not mentioned any ID here. I am referring to the example number 7. Dollar is always implies that this is a jQuery statement. So what is this jQuery statement is doing? What is the use of this jQuery? What is the once you execute this statement, what is going to happen? Can anybody tell me? Hash contents space UL stands for what?
Unordered list.
Dot people. What does it mean? Unordered list dot people means what is the meaning of this?
So people is, I think, a child of unordered list.
Very good. Yes, people is the child of unordered list. In that unordered list tag, you have a list of peoples actually. One people list li is going to give the value of that unordered list. So, but my question here is hash contents. What is this hash contents refers to?
So I think hash content is the name of the parent of the UL.
Yes. So it is one of the element which is having one division. Actually, you can have it as a division name or any particular section name of your web elements. But that section name is nothing but your contents, and you are referring to this contents, that section, using this particular, always in the dollar followed by your, if you are referring to, or if you are selecting, or you are accessing, selecting, referring, all these three words means the same in this context, please. So if you are referring to a particular section with the name contents, that is to be given with the hash contents. Under that you have an unordered list with a certain people list of items. Example 8, just see various ways again. Can you, anybody tell me what is this first statement is referring to? The first example 8, the first statement. Dollar refers to jQuery statement, yes. And in that jQuery statement, what is that function? That is open brace. Within that, you have written single quotes a dot external colon first. So what does it refers to? You are selecting some elements here.
A is the hyperlink tag.
Yeah, anchor tag. You should say hyperlink. Yes, hyperlink, or you can say anchor tag. A is anchor tag. So anchor tag, that A itself is an anchor tag. So you are not writing the tag name here by directly referring to this tag itself, the anchor tag dot external. It means that this is a statement which is equivalent to, you are writing your a href is equal to something, so that you are writing like this here, please. A dot external, you are referring to a particular first URL or second URL or something like that. What about the second jQuery statement is related to what?
Table row.
Table row, TR. TR is basically a tag. Tag name again for the referring to table row. Again, the table row is referring to odd elements of the table. Right. Now the third statement, what is the third statement is referring to? The third form. Statement, yes, please.
Form ID.
There is a form. The name of that form ID is my form here. You are referring to that hash my form. And in that form, you have several input elements. What can be those input elements like?
Text.
Text box. Yes, your text box. Your buttons.
And buttons.
Yeah, your list box. Your combo box, all that input types. So when you write a jQuery statement like this, hash my form colon input, it is referring to all input like elements that are there in that particular form called my form. Similarly, the fourth statement, dollar, what is this dollar followed by div colon visible?
Division.
Yes, it is one division, one section of your web page. So that section of that web page, either you can make it as hidden or you can make it as visible. So whenever you are playing with that kind of things, you can write like this. Yes, now coming to next fifth statement, dollar div, GT stands for greater than, and in that you have specified two. Can you tell me what is this implies? There are divisions in your web page. And which division are you referring by writing this statement like this? By writing the statement like statement number 5? There are different divisions in your web page. So the division number is 0, division number 1, division number 2, division number 3, division number 4, something like that. So here GT2 indicates, of course, the index numbers always starts with 0. Please remember here in jQuery, always you are indexing for your any arrays or for your functional parameter values and all, you start with your zeros. So here anything that is all except the first three divisions. So it means this statement is referring to those divisions which are there, which are more than your three divisions. It means division number 3, division number 4, division number 5. They are referring to. So then a sixth statement, what is the sixth statement is referring to? If that particular division is having certain kind of animation, certain movement or some transformations, so you can use that jQuery statement like that. So please remember, in your jQuery statements, as you have seen here, we can use visible and as well as hidden. So these two parameters, like you have seen here, division is going to be visible or hidden. So this visible or hidden is for whom? Can anybody tell me it is meant for the users who are using that web page? So a particular division can be hidden for viewing purpose. If you make it as visible, it is going to be visible. Otherwise, if you make it as hidden, it is hidden from the users here. Can you tell me some applications or scenarios where this feature is going to be more useful? When certain division elements of your web page can be hidden or when it is required to be shown. For what type of applications, please?
One example can be if we enter a certain value, only then the next
based on the selected value of the user. Some values has to be hidden, some values has to be shown to the user based on the selected value. Are you getting this point? Maybe sometimes when you are filling the application form, if you are in a particular age range, you need to have certain parameters to be entered. If you are in a certain category, you need to enter certain values. If you are belonging to some other category, you have to enter some other category values. So based on the category you choose or you make an option, accordingly the other set of fields has to be visible. So for that particular purpose, you need to have the divisions to be either be hidden or your visible. Some description I have given to you. Please go through those description. Of course, I'm not going to read this. You can read it on your own pace. So then comes to choosing selectors. Here sometimes jQuery will allow us to choose certain values in some other form also, something like the attributes. So if you see here, if there is an attribute for a particular whose real attributes ends with thing or something like that, you can easily put that particular value like this, and you can access those particular values. It means you can choose or select those values. So you can even give the attributes inside that dollar function itself. That is a jQuery function itself. If you are going to select more number of statements or more number of values, then you can use something like dot length. If you are choosing more number of elements of that particular section, the section name is foo, then if you are going to use more number of values, if you are having more number of values for that section foo, and if you want to count how many values are there for that or the elements in there in that division, you can use it with the length function also. You can give the length function like this. So sometimes you have to collect the values and you have to store it locally for your programming purpose. So you can use the dollar div and you can get that particular value and store it locally into your client side, and you can do the processing. This is local storage. So you can use different variable values for your different purposes. So like this, you can just go through it, and more importantly, refining and filtering. Sometimes in your divisions and you have to use certain access conditions or some restrictions in selecting some values, something like refining, or you have to filter certain values from a set of values. So something like this. So here in the first example, you have a division with the name foo. Of course, you are going to access or you are going to select only with the tag name p. Of course, the tag name, paragraph tag name, which has a fee. So this foo division as having a paragraph p, only that particular paragraph text is going to be selected here from this statement when it is executed in your program. Similarly, second statement gives you the heading h1. The heading h1 does not contain the bar value, the class of bar set of values, bar elements. Similarly, the third instruction gives you unordered list of elements where you are going to filter it by specifying the condition. How do you list only those values which are with the current class? Dot current. The dot current refers to the class name. So you want to display or you want to access only those list of items which are with belonging to the class current. And sometimes you can simply use this dollar symbol, dollar unordered list, the list of elements, only the first unordered list element only you are looking for. So you can just extract that first unordered list element using a simple statement, dollar el list dot first. And suppose you are referring to your unordered list of elements of the sixth element in that list, then which is, you can specify equal to operator with the index number, which is referring to the sixth element of your list. So these, something like in the array you can use it, in the list elements you can use it. So directly you can access and you can select it. So these are the some kind of selections which are basically refining and filtering. So you need not access all those elements. You can just use this function. That is what the jQuery function is. This jQuery function will help you to retrieve only certain set of values which you are very much required in your program. If you have to write a JavaScript program for this, can anybody tell me some logic? How do you write this dollar unordered list with picking up only the first element of the unordered list element? Hello, am I audible to you, please?
Oh, yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, can you please tell me if I have an unordered list of elements, something like list 1, list 2, list 3, list 4, list 5, some 5 elements are there. If you have to pick only the first element from that unordered list, and you have to do that picking means, picking up means your program should pick up your program has to filter, your program has to select only the first element, and you have to write a JavaScript program. Can you please write a JavaScript program for this or not?
So can you repeat it again, the question?
Right. Shankanil, let me see here carefully. Okay, if you see here, okay, I think these are the table values are there, at least right. So how many list items are there here? Can you tell me when I highlighted my on my screen?
Seven.
Yes, seven items are there. Now I want to write a script to pick, to select or to choose only this particular, the first item.
Yes, sir.
I want to write a JavaScript for this.
Sir, not in jQuery.
Not in jQuery. I want to write a JavaScript program. Can you write it?
So we can use get element by tag name.
Where is the here, the tag name here? The sir, tag name is li.
Yeah.
How do you identify this? Tell me, there is no ID here. The list item.
It will give an array of all the li's. So we can reference the first element of the array. It will be list item one.
Of course, yes, it is not that it is not possible to write the program. You can write the program, and if you are writing that program with the help of JavaScript, do you know how many lines of code you are writing that one? Yes, please. I don't want the exact number of lines, but at least do you know how much time it takes and
nine lines at least.
Yes, it will be definitely more than 4-5 lines based on your logic. Am I right?
Yes,
if you don't want to write that 4-5 lines of program or 9 lines of program, you can simply use the fourth statement which I'm showing you here, $ul list of dot first. Obviously, it gives me the first element. If you're looking for something like sixth element, you can simply write unordered list of elements dot eq5, the index number. Again, this refers to that particular sixth element only. So this is the advantage of writing the jQuery statements. If you have some hundreds of elements, something like customers are there, hundreds and 200 customers are there. So your program should be able to fetch that program, means your program should be able to fetch it very quickly. And your programming logic should be in such a way that from thousands of customers or thousands of items in a particular web page, which has been displayed with many elements, you need to immediately filter, or you have to refine this. Then your jQuery is the most appropriate function to be used rather than your JavaScript itself. So that is the beauty of this jQuery here, please. Similarly, the jQuery, you can use it. Of course, am I clear to you now? Am I clear to you?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So right now, moving forward, we can just see how do you access the form elements. See, definitely in your user interface of your web pages, there will be different form elements. So the form elements can be something like you can have a buttons, you can have check boxes, even those boxes can be checked or disabled or enabled. You'll have files, you'll have images, you'll have different set of input items in your forms, including your list boxes, your other sets, the passwords, radio buttons, resets, selected, submit buttons, text boxes itself. These are all the different inputs that you need to look for. So here, if you want to access all those form elements at a time, please remember, when you are trying to access all the form elements at a time, you can use the jQuery statement directly. So $myForm, that is the form name, colon input. So it gets all elements that can accept those inputs which you have put in the form itself. So you need not worry about writing the JavaScript program to select a particular form element one by one, or CSS selectors you need to use it, something like this. You need not worry. Only your jQuery statements will be helpful for you to select or to choose all those elements. Now, another feature of this jQuery is a chaining process is going to be most advantageous when you have a long chain of hierarchical set of objects or hierarchical set of elements in the web page. So that involves a lengthy procedure for your JavaScript in accessing these chained objects or chained elements. So that can be easily accessible by writing simply using the jQuery statements with the methods, the common methods such as setters and getters. So setters will always set a value for an element which is in the long chain in the web page itself, and getters obviously will get the value and you can store it onto your local variables. So getting and setting can be easily done with the help of jQuery statements. So for example, if you see this chaining process here, can anybody tell me what is this example is relating to? The chaining example number 13. So if you are calling a method on a selection and that method returns a jQuery object, you can continue to call the jQuery methods on the object without pausing for a semicolon. So you can continuously call that objects. So here there are different levels of objects are there. Can anybody tell me what is the meaning of this sentence?
It will find the element with ID content and then all the H3 elements which are inside it, and then
inside the content division. Please tell like that. Inside the content division, the elements, the heading section, head section, three elements which have been, if they are available, they have been find. What does the find method does? For the jQuery statement, find method is something like a search operation. So searching for certain H3 heading section in the division of content itself, and which is equivalent to, yes, please, EQ in brackets 2. What does it mean, please?
Third element.
Your third element. Please don't say second element. It is indexing starts from 0 here, 0, 1, 2. EQ 0 implies first element. EQ 1 implies second element. EQ 2 implies the third element. And that third element is given with a new value. What is that new value? That new text for the H3, that is the heading section, that you are assigning that value. So you are going in the chaining process. This process that is going to the low levels, going from one object to the next elements in that. So here the content itself is one division. Inside the content division, you will finding the H3, and inside that H3 again you are looking for the third sentence, and for that third sentence you are replacing with. So you are setting it. You are giving a new value. You are setting a value here. So anything that HTML followed by open brace is nothing but you are setting the value to that particular element, which is basically the H3 element, which is the third H3 element in the content division. So that is what you are moving forward in the hierarchical manner here. So similarly, that is the chaining process. If you format it here in this particular notation, if you see in this notation, there is no formatting. Just the logical meaning is there, moving from one level to another level. That is finding the correct corresponding element of that web page. If you look to that, if you format like this in the separate lines for each level, so inside that content division, you can find for an H3 section, H3 heading, and again in that H3 heading, there is a third text belonging to that H3 heading should be replaced, or it is not there. There is no replacing here, but once you give it within the HTML, the value here, whatever you specify in this function, you are going to set that value. Please remember it. So that is basically setting that particular value here. Once you set it, and if you want to restore it further, if you change your selection in the chaining process during the execution itself, you can provide that function, you can get back that function to get back to your original value. You can use this dollar function itself so that you get back to your values here. So you can write it, restores the selection of all H3s in the content with the EQ, and you get back to the first sentence of that H3 section, which is the third one. So you are going to restore it. Means once you change it also, again you can get it back to this restore section, which is being stored onto your web browser here. That's what the web cache can help you to recover it back, restoring the back to your original value. So chaining is an extraordinarily powerful, and its feature that mainly libraries have adapted. That's what the jQuery has got, the chaining process that is the most advantageous, so that you can access very depth level elements which are having a more hierarchies in the sense, more than, of course, there is no limit for this chaining process. It all depends on how much level you can, the programmer, the developer can go. But please remember, there is a if the more the levels, like 10, 12, 13, 15 levels, if you go, it will be very complex also for the a new developer who is going to trace out what is the logic behind of that one. It will be very difficult task. So let us move forward to the getters and setters. So here, jQuery, it overloads its methods. Please remember, what is overloading? So please tell me what you mean by overloading here, or in this context, what you mean by overload? A method is getting overloaded. Hello, am I audible to you, please?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, well, see, there is an object-oriented programming concept is there here. jQuery overloads its methods. Methods means your functions. So what is meant by overloading?
Same
function name and different parameters.
Yeah, same function name, different parameters. It is another name, we call it as polymorphism. So some of you might have studied Java. If those who have studied Java programming, you can recollect it. But those who have not studied Java programming, let us see with some small example here what is overloading. So the function name here, please see here, if you see that example 16, so you have a jQuery statement like this, $H1, that is a heading section, the heading section element H1, .html, you have given the hello world here. Please look into this carefully, the hello world. So you have setter, you have set the value, you have set the value to your HTML, for the HTML content. This is the HTML content that you are going to set it for your heading section 1. So the function name is going to be the same, but you are going to have different parameters. So see here, what is the parameter here? So what is the parameter that I am referring here is, that I am referring to hello world, a simple text parameter here. So sometimes this HTML is without parameters also. So when you see an HTML without parameters, what you see is like this. .html without parameters. So the same function is there, but without parameters. So when you write without parameters, it is basically called as getter, the HTML method, which is used for getting the values, getting the HTML content values of the heading section 1. Whereas in the previous case, in the previous example number 16, you see the HTML has got a parameter here. So in this example number 17, there is no parameter, but the function name is going to be the same. Function name is same, the method name is same. Method or a function in object-oriented programming terminology, we can use function or you can call it as a method. So the method is having the same name, but the different parameters here. So here, of course, there is no other parameter. So no other parameter is different from with one parameter. So basically this process of this having same method name, but with different parameters or different parameter values, we call it as overloading. That's why jQuery, this same statements, it supports the function names with different set of values. That's why you call it as these methods are overloaded, loaded with many other values, many other functionalities in simple terms. So you can use this getter and the setter functions, please remember, in the jQuery to get a value from the existing element, or you to set a new value to an existing element. You can use like this. This process is called as a getter, getting and setting. In other terms, it is also called as getters and setters. So this, let us move to the CSS styling and dimensions. How jQuery is going to be used in this. So far you have seen how jQuery is going to be used in the forms, and how jQuery can be used as a chaining process in accessing the elements, and how jQuery can be used to retrieve certain division values and other things. So similarly, we can use this jQuery for our CSS, those contents or your those information which is there in your cascading styles, for your styling and dimensions of your elements or objects. we can use those CSS same methods, the same functionalities can also be combined with your jQuery's. So some example like this, very simple example. So if you want to get some CSS properties, you want to get some collect what is the font size of the cascading styles for the heading section one. So for the heading section one, you might have put some font size. So heading section contains certain font size. So what is that is already been assigned in your CSS. If you want to know it in your scripting logic or in your business logic or in your web page, then you can simply use the statement $h1.css font size. So this font size is referring to your basically the font size element or the attribute value, that attribute which is referring in your from your CSS file. So again, if you want to directly write it, the jQuery here, the camel size, which is camel size, or we call it as camel size expressions, you can put it with this type of notation also. You can also use in the jQuery font hyphen size. This is also correct. There is no wrong. This is a different ways of these things. Sometimes you want to set. So using the setters. So if you want to set a new font size other than the existing in the CSS definition file, or you want to give something new, so directly you can access that CSS element, that H1 CSS characteristics, the properties. So $h1.css, you want to set with a new value. Suppose earlier it was 19 pixels. Now you want to put it a new value at a different location or at a different context or at a different place on your web page. So then you can put this new value, you are going to set it. So 100 pixels are going to be set as a font size for your heading section one, H1. That's what you can, everything is written in one just simple line using your jQuery. So that is the advantage of setting the values, getting the values of your web elements very easily. And it is going to be very much useful for programming very complex applications. So you can go through these other descriptions at your own pace, read it, properly understand it. If you are having difficulty, you can ask me in the in today's class or in the next class, it's up to you. So similarly, working with classes. So what does a class implies in our HTML or your programming aspects? Am I audible to you, please?
Yes, sir, audible.
Yeah, so what does this class, how do you handle the classes with the jQuery? That one example is there here. So there is a class name called Big. So you are going to remove, or you are going to toggle it, or if there is a class, if you want to check it with the by the name Big itself. So you are going to assign this for this heading section. If you are going to assign the class itself, so what does the class contains? This difference between a class and a non-class I have given you some time back. Can you please recollect it? What is the class? What does the class element contain? Hello. Very simple answer, please. I don't want the exact textbook definition.
Class, yes, please. Is an HTML attribute, sir, just like name and ID.
Yes, it's simply like get element by ID, get element by name, get element by class, get element by tag. You might have used this. What is this class indicates? Class contains a collection of Class is nothing but an entity, Baba. Please don't forget. Very simple answer. A class is an entity, or a class means, you can say, suppose if now I have an object called a pen. Yes, this is a pen. This object, there is an object pen. So now I want to define what are the characteristics and what are the behaviors of this pen. Can anybody tell me what is this? What is the characteristics of this pen? Characteristics means properties. What are the properties of this pen? Hello. Yes. Am I audible to you, please? Yes. So what can be the properties of this of an object pen? which I'm referring to with some small example here. You can take it any object, any real world object. You can take a laptop, you can take a book, you can take a mouse is there. You can take a keyboard, you can take a glass, you can take a fan, you can take a light, different objects, any. So assume that you are now referring to one example. I'm referring to a pen. What are the characteristics of a pen? Characteristics means properties. What are the characteristics? How do you distinguish an object from another object? Or how do you differentiate it?
Maybe color.
Yes, a pen. This pen has got a color. This color is differentiating with another pen. So color is one attribute, one characteristic, one property. Not only color, what are the other things that you can easily make a distinction between one object? Yes, please.
Brand, it's dimension.
Brand, okay, brand, yes, brand, color.
Dimensions.
Dimensions, very good. So this pen has got certain length. This pen has gotten certain length, certain height. So the dimensions are going to be useful. Okay, what are the other properties this object can have? There's only dimensions and color, brand, only these material, three attributes. Sorry?
Material and kind of type of pen.
Yes, type of pen.
Ink
pen or a ballpoint pen, different types. Kind. Yes. So these are all, okay, now tell me what is the behaviors of this object? Behavior. What is the functionality of this object? For what purpose are we going to use this object?
Writing
purpose. Very good. So this main purpose is to write or to erase whatever you have written. Sometimes if the erasing option is given, you can erase it. Or to not only writing, you can draw an object. So drawing, writing, erasing, all these are different methods, different functionalities that which you can do it with using this particular pen. So if you combine these, all this together, the characteristics and the behavior together. So if you combine them as a single unit or as a function, as a particular unit containing your characteristics and behavior, is basically nothing but your class. A class is nothing but, I'm now telling this, a class as a pen. This pen class has got different characteristics, different behaviors. Similarly, I have another object, book. Can you tell me that a book object, if I put, what are the characteristics of that book? Yes, please. Of course, this is an object-oriented programming concepts, but this is, some people might have not studied or not known or something like that. But anyway, you need to know these things from, at least because until unless you don't have this object information, the object concepts, then sometimes it will be difficult to even to handle the web pages, web elements also. That is why I'm just taking a little bit time here. So what is then a book? What is the characteristics of a book or what are the properties of a book? Everybody knows it. Of course, you are not coming forward to, yes, book is going to be having a information of published year, publishing year. Very good, Tawab. So publishing year is one of the important attribute. I can call it as an attribute, I can call it as a characteristic, I can call it as an property. Properties, characteristics, attributes, all three means the same. So book has got an author, yes, the book has got a publisher name, book has got number of pages. Number of pages is one attribute. It is a characteristic. It is a property. Similarly, for what purpose are you going to use for book? What is the behavior of the book? In general, if you talk about a book, for what purpose? The book is meant for reading. The book is meant for writing. The book is meant for drawing. So drawing, reading, writing, these are all the methods. These are all the functions. These are all the behaviors. So if I put the characteristics of that object and the behaviors together as a single unit, we call it as basically a class. So class contains, so you know, you tell me, what does a class contain? Can anybody tell me in just simple one or two lines, what does a class contain?
So it contains the properties of a class of objects. It is a basically a blueprint based on,
yes,
which
it is a blueprint. Yes, a class contains,
objects are instantiated.
Yes, objects are instantiated with that class. Yes, it contains attributes, Yes, the properties and attributes, or you can call it as attributes, or you can call it as your own name, characteristics, attributes, properties, plus the behavior. Behaviors means functionalities, the methods. Each object has its own behavior. Each object has its own functionality. So when you put these together, the characteristics and the functionalities, these together, then you say that that is been called as a blueprint of an object that is nothing but a class. Similarly, why I'm referring to this class here is we have certain class containing certain characteristics and as well as certain behaviors. So those class characteristics and behaviors can be given to certain divisions or sections or elements of your web pages itself. So when you assign it, you can assign it by adding that class name to that section with your assigning a local variable, or you can remove those things, or you can ascertain like this using the jQuery. It is possible to have. Similarly, when you are discussing about the jQuery in the CSS itself, you may be referring to something like this. So $h1.width. So what is this? Is it a setter or it is a getter?
Setter.
It is a setter, yes. So this jQuery set, statement is basically a setter setting the width with the 50 pixels for of all the h1 elements. So whatever the h1 heading section has got, if it is a text, that particular text, or if it is an image, or if you are putting something like that, you can make that one. So here, the second statement is basically a getter. If you are not setting up, obviously the other thing is getting the values. So what is that existing values are there, you are going to retrieve it. Retrieving or accessing it or getting it, all three means the same here. So these are the, you can just set the values, your width, the height, you can put the positions. So with a single line of statement, single jQuery statement, you can set values, you can get the values of your CSS attributes and the dimensions and so on and so forth. That is the advantage of your jQuery here, please. So similarly, you can also set attributes to your anchor tag. So the anchor tag is your hyperreference tag. So if you have something like this, you can put your anchor tag like this. So $a is an anchor tag that attribute. So one of the attributes is, if you want to write it in your script file or in your scripting language, how do you write this one? Can anybody tell me? If you see this example 22, if you have to write it in the JavaScript, so what is that you are going to write it in the JavaScript? Yes, please. Hello, am I audible to you, please?
Yes, sir, you're audible.
Yeah, so in the anchor tag in your normal JavaScript, you write A, something like this. I'm just showing you to here again on the screen. So you A, then followed by href is equal to quotes, then followed by, you close the anchor tag, then followed by something like link to, then you close the actual anchor tag. So you use something like sample.html. So some people write this, if your external reference is there, you can write like this. If you are going to have an internal reference, you are going to write src is equal to like this. So instead of writing, and you can have the other attributes also. What are the other attributes of this anchor tag? Can anybody tell me one or two other attributes? So one attribute is src, I have written here, or it can be href. What are the other attributes you have? You can have a title, you can have a blank target. If you want to open it in a new window or a new tab, you can write it through a blank tag. So like this, you can have other things. Instead of writing all this in your JavaScript file, using your jQuery, you can directly mention, so these are the attributes, that is a title, href, your blank tag is there. This is basically, it is referring to, what type of format is this one? Hello? This is basically your JSON format. So JSON, this is what your attributes and the corresponding values, your attributes in the colon. So colon is a separator for your attributes and the corresponding values. So that you can write it in this form also along with your jQuery. that will be most convenient for the developer as well as for the browser to go about getting the values here. So sometimes now let us move forward to the traversing. Traversing is moving from one element to another element. So how do you move moving around the DOM elements? How do you use this jQuery statements to move from one element to another element? So suppose you have a heading section one, and in that heading section, along with that, you have something like your, if you want to access the values which are very parent of that particular section or division section, or if you want to, which is the children of that one, or if you want to looking for the siblings. So looking to the DOM structure itself, if you want to access or if you want to move from one place to another place, from one element to another element on your web page, you can use the jQuery statement and you can move about those elements here. So sometimes you may have to use this jQuery statements as a looping statements with various elements. So here you can use your in the jQuery itself supports your it's equivalent to for each. If you might have seen the for loop, so in that each is going to be there. So for each iteration, you are going to execute a function that needs to be displaying the elements, all the elements are getting changed here. If you want to put it in a loop for that particular thing in that list of elements, how the list of elements are getting updated, you can iterate those set of values using your jQuery itself. So you can write the jQuery dollar followed by the list, the my list elements, and for each element of that one in the iteration, display one by one elements. You can element, you use the dollar element.html. It will display the corresponding value for it. So coming to manipulating the elements, it's nothing but you are getting and setting the values. That's what we have seen, the getter and the setter values using your jQuery. So some of the notes I have given to you, very important things that you need to please go through the notes properly. So basically the notes is nothing but in comparison to the JavaScript, those points are there. So you can use this height function value for all the elements along with the jQuery. So anything that is preceded with the dollar with the function dot position, dot value, dot width, dot height always refers to those corresponding elements. So you can set a new values to this. You can move, you can copy, you can remove it with your jQuery. So in all about, your jQuery is very much flexible in handling the DOM objects very easily. That's what all these things is. So sometimes you want to clone the elements too. If you want to have the same kind of array elements or same kind of list, so you can use $.function.clone. You can use that clone function. It obviously creates another object. So like this, it is my list. First elements it been cloned with the my list itself. You create another object, my list, for different purposes for your different applications. Sometimes you have to remove those elements dynamically based on the user's interactivity, and sometimes you have to create also. You can use the creation of new elements, or this is a paragraph element, very paragraph element. Of course you can use it with HTML with the simple p tag, but you can use it with the dollar also. It is going to be useful for you. So something like this, you can get the element. So you need to practice this one. Please go through each and every example here. How do you assign new values? How do you delete it? How do you insert it to a set of values? All this has to be practiced by you rather than I explain. I'm explaining to you, even if I demonstrate to you, the same thing has to be done by you. Until unless you don't do, you will not be able to grasp the actual concept behind this. So here, this is one small example. You are using the jQuery statement. So you are creating a my list elements, and you are adding that elements or appending that elements to that my list. Can anybody tell me what will be the expected output of this one? So my list, my items is an array, where my items is an array, and dollar my list is equal to dollar hash of my list. You are creating the my list of elements. So for variable I from 0 to 100, so my items dot push. So this my items is basically your array. That array items is being inserted with the items. So what elements are this array is getting inserted with, or the what element the array is being pushed with? Yes, the yes, please.
Item 0 to.
Of course, yes. Very simple. You are starting with 0 and you are incrementing the I values. For every I value, you are incrementing that and you are pushing it to your array itself here. And whatever the array which has been created for you, that is my items, is again appended to your. Appended to what? Appended means it is added to which? So the array my items, once it is prepared, it is appended to which particular element?
My list.
Yes, please. Yeah, my list. This is my list itself is another which you have created here. So that my list dollar my list is there here, which is getting appended with this. So it is existing. So this dollar my list is equal to hash my list. It is having existing elements. Now these elements are also going to be appended to the existing elements. So just do this practice here. You will definitely get more information once you do it. So manipulating the multiple attributes of your anchor tag. If you are doing something, certain things like manipulating this is a single attribute. If you are doing multiple attributes like href and relative links, or your two different attributes are there, if you want to manipulate it at a time, you can manipulate through those set of values. So let us now move to exercises, please. So open the file exercises/index.html in your browser and work to accomplish the following. So I will just share the index.html on the Moodle course page. You download it and please tell me the solutions one by one. So let us have a quick interaction here for today. And once we complete it, I will give time for you to execute whatever you are trying to say for this. So there are around 15 questions and I will expect each one of you to give one answer for at least one query. So the file is, let me upload the file onto the exercises and you download it and please respond to that. I'm giving the extension as .txt. Once you download it, you make it as an HTML and save it on your file. Or save it onto your local system. You can download the file now. I kept it here, exercises/index.html. Of course, you just change the name to .txt to HTML on your local system and open the file, please. Am I clear to you? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So please open this file. This is just an HTML file. Please open this file. Are you able to access it?
Yes, sir. It's accessible.
Yeah. So just store it on your local drive. Store means save it in your local drive. And now, who is going to answer this first question? Select all of the div elements that have a class module on that HTML file, on that index file. Can anybody open the file once you are able to store it locally? Yes, Yes, please. Hello, am I audible to you?
Yes, sir, you are audible.
Yeah. Sachin Saha, can you present from your side once the file index.html?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. I'll stop presenting from my side. You please present from your side so that other students can also see. If not Sachin sir, anybody, anyone can volunteer this. Yeah, yes, Subham, is it possible for you?
Yes, sir.
Can you?
Should I share?
Yeah, yeah, please share. I'm just waiting for that.
Visible, right?
Yeah, it's visible.
Yeah. I just opened that index file. Open that. Ah, very good, fine. Just go top. Right. All right. All right. So, can you open the script of this one? Open the script file also, the side by side. Yeah. Yes. So, let me start with you only then. All right. I hope everybody can see those the actual file. And of course, I do not have that figures from that website. I cannot download it. You can just put some images, whatever, like fruits and vegetables, if you want to, like, if you have something, you can be good looking, that's fine. Okay, what is the first question here, please? The selection, how do you write a jQuery statement to select all of the div elements that have a class of module? Have you understood the question now? Yes, Subham, have you understood the question?
So, what was the question?
Okay. Even the question also, you can open it. You can open the question there. Is it possible to open the material for you, the question? Very simple answers only, Baba. Nothing, no need to worry.
No, actually, I missed the last class.
No, this is not the last class. This is today's class only. In fact, okay, I'll just show you. Can you open the just maximize a little bit? Yes. So yes, the first question is select all of the div elements that have a class of the class module. Name is module. Yeah, can you go to the script file now?
Yes.
Can you find just go to find where is don't change anything there, no problem. Just go to find, go to edit menu option. What happened? You just find for the module. So there is a class called module here, right?
Yes.
So I want to display this using a jQuery statement. Is there any other class called module?
Yes, there is multiple.
There are multiple modules are there. Now please tell me, how many modules are there here? Okay. So how, you just you have to write. Now go to another editor. Now open a new file in the editor.
Script file or HTML?
New file.
Yes, I am asking the what is the extension of the file.
It will be just write solution.txt. Okay, now the first question answer. So always your jQuery statement should start with $, yes, open brace, closing brace, fine. What is that question is? Get all of the div elements. So what should be this starting should be there. Yes, within quotes, that is a function, very good. Then you are looking for the section name division, yes, div dot, yes, the name of the divisions which you are looking for, module, that's it. That is the simplest answer for that. Save that one.
Okay.
Yeah, save that. Now come to the second question. Yes. Who can answer it? Niklesh. Niklesh, are you online? I think Niklesh is having some problem. Okay, Sachin Saha. Now you please keep presenting, no problem. Suvam. Is
yes.
It okay?
Yes.
Yeah, please. Yeah, otherwise it will just simply kill our time. Everybody starts presenting and stopping and all. He will tell the answer. You will just write down. Okay, I'll help him. Okay, Niklesh, no problem. Next time we'll try. Yeah, anyone who will come forwards for the second question? What is the second question is? Can you just display the second question here? Yes. So come up with three selectors that you could use to get the third item in the my list unordered list, which is the best to use by. Answer has to be there. Please tell me. First, you have to come up with a jQuery statement that needs to list, that needs to get the third item in the my list unordered list. Can anybody come try forward? jQuery statement. Okay.
I will try.
Yeah, please try. So, yeah.
Shubham, right?
Yeah, please. Shubham, can you please type there if you don't mind?
$.
Yes, $. Open brace, closing brace.
Closing.
Very good. Yes, within that quotes.
UL.
Okay.
It's list li space.
Okay, UL dot li. Dot, why dot is coming for
space.
UL space li
dot at the end dot.
At the end dot li dot. Okay, you mean to say li dot list of li. Okay.
No, after the closing braces.
Okay, you are selecting the list of unordered list item. Okay, you mean to say your idea is that?
Yes.
Can you put the question there? Yeah. You need to write three selecting statements that you could use to get the third item. That will get the third item in the my list unordered list. So if you go to the script file.
Okay, my list. Okay. So
there is a my list ID, is there. My list itself is the ID here. Very good. Very good. Yes.
Hash.
Please this my list. Very good. Remove that UL and LI. my list, if you want to get the third one, then already I have given that in the example when I am discussing how to get the third element of that
dot eq to
my list space. Yes, that is a division ID, my list space li list item li colon what is that you said just now, eq equal to list item equal to eq 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 which item?
2
2 yes,
in the round
open brace again, open the brace within that 2. Yes, this is one semicolon. Okay semicolons, everything that jQuery in the first one also is semicolon. Yes fine, this is one. What is the other one? What is the other way to select the element, the third element from the my list? My list is there. You come up means you have to write three different selectors. One selector you have written, one way to select the third element of that list you have selected it. There is another way also to select the third element by looking to this, the script file.
Hashtag my list item.
Yeah, very good. Hashtag my list item. The third element ID itself is my list item here. Hashtag yes, my list item. That directly you can pick that particular ID if you know the ID here, my list item. My list item, mama. Item, the ID name is there. That ID is there. Directly you are specifying the ID here. My list item. Very good. This is second way. So this is not the answer for third question. Second question itself, there are three answers are required. Shubham, don't type this as a third. Yeah, yes. What is the third solution? The third selector. One way is to select the index number. The other way is to select the ID number. Yes. The third way is dollar. Very good. Open brace, quotes open. Yes. My list. Right on my list. My list is the division name. Hash my list. Space. Hash my list item. Hash my list item. So these are the three ways, but among these three, which is the best way?
ID one directly.
Yeah. Which one?
Direct using ID.
Yeah, if ID is not there, how do you get the third item then? Yeah, if ID is not there, you have to refer to your index number. That is the only thing. Yes. If IDs are there, the ID is the best one. If IDs are not there, then the first solution is the best thing. Okay, now come to the third question, please. Select the label for the search input using an attribute selector. Select the label for the search input. There is a search input is there. Please open the script file, Shubham. Yeah, in that. Now you are looking for the third solution. So there is an input for the search. You just go to Control F and find search. It will be in the top only. Yes. So there is a search. Okay, now come to the question again. Select the label for the search input using an attribute. Using an attribute selector. Yeah, that is what you can use any of those attributes there. Can you open the script file? Yes. So there is an there are for this search. How many labels means how many different tags are there here? One label, only one label is there, right?
Yes.
What is the attribute for that label? Anyone can answer. I forgot to ask. Who can volunteer, please? Abhinav?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Can you tell me? See, on the left side of the screen, there is a label tag is there for the search ID. Can you see that one?
Yes, sir. So for is equal to Q. For is the attribute.
For is the attribute. Very good. So how do you write it in the jQuery now? If you are going to write that in the jQuery statement. Start with dollar. There is no need to think about it. Dollar, open brace, closing brace, yes, within the quotes. Now you need to access, how do you select that? Selecting that label with the attribute.
And hashtag search.
Hashtag is not going to be used here. The tag name, if you are not referring to ID, there is, or a tag name, you don't need to use a hash. You are referring to the tag itself. So the tag here is?
Label.
Label, yes, write down label. Yes, label, then label. How do you write that attribute? How do you write that attribute here? Label within the braces. Yes, for is equal to Q, the attribute and the corresponding value. Yeah, come to the fourth question now. Vinod Kumar. Very simple question. Vinod?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Can you try for the fourth question?
Yes, sir. 1 minute.
Yeah, very simple. Okay, please, all of you, please try all these questions. I will be anyway online only. I'll just pause for 10 to 15. Now the time is 3:35, so I will come back within 10 minutes, 3:45. So in meantime, please try for those question answers, please, all of you, for traversing as well as for manipulation. Is it okay? Yeah, Praveen has given some answer on the chat box. V Praveen. Okay, that is for the attribute previous case. Yes, fine, that is okay, already completed. So I will come back again and join the session after 10 minutes. So in meantime, please try to answer, and again I'll ask somebody to respond to this. Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, so please keep trying. Any doubts, you can ask me. So for that, you please refer to the material and as well as this question and the exercise. Yes, please. Any queries? Any doubts regarding this jQuery implementation? Of course, you have to practice it. Until unless you don't practice the jQuery with the examples, what is being discussed here. The main important things have been discussed here. Please do practice it. Okay, coming to the fourth question. Find out how many elements on the page are hidden. Did anybody try? Very simple question and direct answer. Hello, am I audible to you?
Yes, sir.
Anybody tried for this? The fourth question? How many means you need to get a number. So to use that number, obviously you are looking for a parameter called which one?
Type equal to hidden.
That is again you are looking for you are going to count how many are been hidden here. You have to count this number of hidden. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So of course that function is hidden only, but how do you count it? Niklesh has given the answer in the chat box. Alert. So alert box, a message box is going to display $document. Yes, document need not be written all the time, Niklesh. It is optional only. So it implies your function for the current document only, which the document is you are considering it. So you can, yes, it is optional document. Yes, absolutely correct. The one which he has given is absolutely correct. You can see the answer in the text box, chat box. Is going to hidden, is going to count the number of lengths. Very good. Fine. Good. Very good. So coming to finding how many image elements. Yes, please. Figure out how many image elements on the page have an ALT attribute. ALT stands for what? For in image attribute, for image tag, the attribute ALT.
Alternate.
What is this? Sorry.
Alternate. If the source mention is not found, then it can.
It can what? It can what?
Replace with the alternate one.
Yeah, usually that alternate is going to be having what? What value is going to be there for the alternate? Alternate text. Very good. So Martha has given that. Very good. So. It is an alternate text. So you put some alternate text value, the image is not existing. Okay, now actually that is not the question here. The question here is, what is that question? You need to find out how many means again, that comes the length for the image elements. So instead of the previous thing is for the hidden, now you are looking for the image elements with the attribute alternate. So again, Niklesh has given alert box he is using to display the value. Find dollar. Yes, img is the tag for the image tag and for the alternate dot length. Very good. Very good, Niklesh. Good. So yes. So now coming to the next question, get all the odd table rows in the table which we are given. Get the all the alt. Figure out how select all the odd table rows in the table body. Anybody apart from Niklesh? Yes, please. Am I audible to you?
Yes, sir. Yeah. TR colon odd dot length, it can be. I'm guessing.
TR?
TR colon
odd, yes, that is enough. TR colon odd, that itself is enough to display the table body values. Good, good, Sachin. Yeah, so of course it should be written in the dollar for the table body again. Yes, so please do practice. Yeah, the other even what are the other queries there? Select all the image elements on the page, log each image alternate attribute values. Yes, please. Select all the, and you need to log. Log means, what is the meaning of log here? Yes, please. It is console.log. Console.log value should be displayed for what?
Alt attribute of image.
Sorry?
Alternative attribute of image.
Alternate elements or alternate text values of those images. If you start counting manually, it will take time. Even if you want to write a JavaScript, it will take time. So how the jQuery is going to be useful for you? When I write a jQuery equivalent programming statement, it's basically a loop statement has to come into picture here. So use the loop statement which I have given in the examples. So how do you write a loop statement? Can you go to the example in the note section in the after the example number 32? So if you look to the example after 32, please look to the example after 32 and try to find out, list all the elements. Image elements, of course, of the page, and display it on the log console. Can you do it? Hello.
Is it audible here?
Yeah. So I think I'm having difficulty in writing how to write that statement. Okay, I'll explain to you how to write the statement. Can anybody come forward to write that one so that I can help you to write? How do you write it? No? Almost all of 50% of the class has left. Okay, is it visible?
Yes, sir.
Yes. So which particular tag, okay, refer to the question here. Select all of the image elements. So all of the image elements on the page and log each image. If you want to log, okay, log means basically you have to write image elements, you are going to select it. All of them. So you have to select all of them means for each of those. And how do you write that each? And you're opening the flower brace and you're closing the flower brace, and this has to be executed as an instruction. Are you getting this point, please? The loop statement. For this image, all the images which are there in the web page, for each image, you are going to do something for each of those. So what is that you have to do? You have to console.log, you have to display it, display the values. But what values has to be displayed here? Those values which are, yes, which are, so how do you write that one? Please tell me. Images alternate attribute value. How do you, just now in the previous exercise, in the question number five, it is you are told you find out how many image elements on the page have an alternate attribute. To tell this, what is the answer you have given?
Dollar image colon alt dot.
Yes, something you have given here. Dollar, yes, dollar image. The same function has to be written here for you. But to access each element and find the corresponding value, so how do you get that value here? Yes, please.
I dot alt.
I dot?
Alt.
Sorry?
Alt.
I'm not getting Ashendra. Yeah, tell me, Ashendra, please. You are trying it. Yes, something funny. Yes, please tell me.
I dot alt.
I dot alt. I value is there. I dot alt. Yeah. Thank how you will get the alt value here? You have to get the image attribute. You have selected it, and for each image, you are trying to do something here, and that needs to be displayed on the console box. How do you select it? Do you have the question with you, Honey?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, can you present it? I'll tell you. You open the script file. First, you open the script file.
Open.
You first find out manually what you will do to find out how do you. Find out what will you do when you see that particular file. You just tell me first manually how do you calculate it or how do you process it. Can you present it from your side? I can just tell you how do you proceed it. Yeah. Yes. So first manually what you do, you tell me in this, if you are just counting by your manual image, you need to count by looking in. So how many images tags are there for each image tag? How many attributes are there? Means, how many alternate attribute image tags are there? In other words,
you will find for image and check.
Yes, so first thing is you are finding the image, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, go to first thing is if you are finding an image in a dollar query, how do you write it? Is open a new file there, as I shown you just just there. Okay, after after yes, you just first tag is image tag you have selected it, right?
Yes, sir.
Image tag. Then each function of I, very good, open flower brace. Okay, now press enter there after open flower brace. Open flower brace. So you are selecting each image here. That is the meaning here. What is that you are doing is you are selecting each image.
Yes, sir.
That image alternate attribute has to be displayed here in the console log. So console log, already Niklesh has given some answer here. Have you seen that answer on the chat box in the
image alt length?
Yes, right on that. Dollar after in the console log. Console log. In the console log, yes. In the console log, you have to log it. Yes, dollar. Yes, after dollar, you have to open brace. Again, same jQuery statement. Open brace, yes.
Image, sir.
Yeah, write down whatever he has written, write down there. Same answer only, nothing else. Count is going to give the number instead of length. You can just remove that length there. Okay. You can go like this simply. This is one way. Okay. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Funny. Yeah. This is one way. You can go the other way. You put it in a temporary variable, this one, and the temporary variable you display it on the console log.
Okay.
You put it in a temporary variable. Otherwise, if you want to, yes. How do you create a temp variable? You write like that only in the jQuery statements. You are inside the jQuery. Please remember it. Write down where. Yes. Where dollar space after where you give some space.
Yes.
Dollar temp is equal to this temp should refer to what? That no, you have to come from that. Okay, you have to come from there. Yes, yeah, okay, remove. You are right. No, that temp should refer to the current image object image tag.
I
dollar this, put just dollar this. This refers to the current image tag. The current object which you are referring in the jQuery is the image tag only. Yes. Remove that. Yes. Now console. Yes, semicolon. Now in the console dog, you put it dollar temp. So dollar temp contains the current image tag. Dot. You are looking for which attribute now? So write down dot attr attribute. In brackets, write down that attribute name. Within quotes. This is another way.
Okay.
If you have to find the length here, if you want to find how many as such that many number of things, then how, what is your answer will be here?
The previous question.
No, this question only. If I add one more thing here. If I add one more thing, what is that? The one more thing is, if I add little bit, how many as such that are available in the web page? So how do I get that value? How many images are there? How many?
You can have a count.
Count will be, for that. What you are going to do for that? What is that to be done for that?
Temp colon alt.
Already you have written that one, no? You have to simply write dollar temp dot attrib within the brackets alternate. After that alternate closing brace is over, dot length.
Here, sir.
Dot length gives you the number of assets the image attribute values are going to be existing. Okay, this is just a beginning, so it will be a little bit difficulty will be there in writing the jQuery's. So please do practice this jQuery's what I have given to you. Okay.
Sir, what is I?
Yes, sir. I have same question.
I also use the same number, which gives you the number of iterations.
So, sir, by using I, we cannot, as I is a one object.
I is one parameter here.
It refers to
the count value for that many number of times each object is getting traversed.
Okay, sir. Okay. Now understood.
So please go through this and practice it and let me know by next week. So I am preparing to conduct a mid-exam kind of stuff for you. Is it okay to write on Sunday?
No, sir.
No, sir.
We have IoT mind.
Yes, sir. We are also.
You also have another exam on that day?
Yes, sir.
So what about coming Tuesday then?
Yes, sir.
Coming Tuesday in our regular class?
Oh, yes, sir. It's fine.
So coming to the regular class, please go through all the up to till today. It will be there. Okay. If you see the syllabus, do you have the syllabus copy with you?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Can you see my screen now?
No, sir.
So Ali Akbar has also given a solution for this one. People can see that solution on the chat box. So if you see the syllabus, so who is regular to the class? Niklesh is regular, Ali Akbar is regular, Sachin Shah is regular, Swam is regular, Mohit Ilstrad is regular. Yes, all these now 18 students were there are all regular. Can anybody tell me where we are now in the syllabus? At what point or at what topic?
So it's in unit 4.
Yeah, we are in the unit 4 now. Please remember, there's only one unit 4 also. We are already almost, this is what creating your jQuery's, working with selections, chaining, getters and setters, CSS styling, these are all over now. At present, copying, removing new elements, manipulating. So I have to complete only the events, utility methods. So, of course, to some extent, the Java, Ajax. So we are already on the unit 4, half of the unit 4 is also over. So except this. So Ajax overview already I given you in the last class, Ajax. So just overview is given. So Ajax related methods, of course, we are not done. So the next class, maybe on Tuesday, I will try to complete these remaining parts. So that completes the unit number 4 and we will start the unit number 5. Hopefully unit number 5, we will start it next to next week. So we are on the track now. Only one unit is left. That is the JSP. So that's okay. That can be done in 3 weeks. That will be completing the syllabus. So, okay, we will for the mid exam accept all these things. But introduction to Ajax is there. So, accept all these things. The remaining everything will be there for the mid exam on the Tuesday. Is it okay?
Sir, what will be the exam? I think written or something, assignment.
Sorry?
I'm asking, I mean, what type of the exam? It will be Viva type or written test? What is that?
Both will be there. Your Viva is will be there as well as Viva. I'm not conduct on that day because it will take a long time for everybody to get the answers. So you need to do some two programs. I will give two programs for you. Okay.
So, I have a request, sir. Can we shift it midterm into the next weekend? Because actually for this week it is I got so many things, so I think I am not able to complete, because for the last class I missed, I am still even I am not able to watch that recording.
Okay, what about others? What about others, please? What is your idea? So next week I will conduct the Viva instead of programming execution. Programming execution, the two programs we will conduct on the next weekend. Is it okay, Sumam?
Yes, the next week I think it will be good, because in this week I have that IoT minor in the weekend. I have a presentation also the day after tomorrow.
Okay, I agree to that one, but. Then one thing I will do. Every week you are doing some assignments that will be there as your continuous assessments. There is no doubt in that. Okay.
This
particular topic I am going to cover, complete it in the next Tuesday. So once I complete this, all 4 units will be completed. All 4 units will have for the next weekend. Is it okay?
Okay.
So, is it able to, will you be able to convey this information to all of you, all of your friends then?
Okay, I will put that into our IT group, and the people from CS, they can convey to in their CS group.
Yeah, see, I think the CR is not there today.
Then I will tell CR.
Yeah, so on what day you are going to plan? I mean, on what day is okay for you?
Okay, we can have in next weekend. I mean, this one weekend day. We have IoT minor. Next weekend we can have that midterm of IT level.
So please let me know the date. That's what date and time. Let us have a word about that. Sorry?
On 4th or 11th?
Sir, we can go on 4th Tuesday in the lab session.
But Sumam is having some problem, that is the thing. Not only Sumam, maybe somebody else also have some problem.
Next week, sir. Next week, 4th. Sumam.
Yes.
Next week Tuesday. It's you having problem with that?
What are you saying? I'm not getting.
I'm saying on the 4th you have problem. 4th of May.
4th May, right?
Yeah.
Next Tuesday.
Okay, we can. I can manage. I think.
No. You have problem, then we can do. No problem. If you have problem.
Okay. We can manage. No problem.
Sir, we'll be getting only 2 to 3 days for preparation.
Okay. Yes, this is a continuous process, Amma. Don't worry about that. I will not ask you to complete within that same day. Okay, I will give 1 day time for you to do it, including the 3 hours of Tuesday.
Oh, okay. Then no problem. Okay. Then no problem.
I will not fix the time. I will give it open. That is open book and open. The only thing is you have to design and develop it. So I will give 1 day time for you to solve 2 problems out of 3 problems. But only 1 day I can give the time. Only 1 day.
Within the end possible, you can give it on weekend, sir. We'll be free and we can.
But this weekend, that's what this weekend, even I have another exam for mine. Another course. Swam, my doubt is, are you just worried about having that exam on that 3 hours slot, something like that?
Yes. If you are
no,
then no problem.
Sorry?
If you are giving 1 day time, then that is not a problem.
1 day time will be given. You don't worry about that. 1 day time will be given.
I thought it will be like Viva or something, written type of thing. That's why I told you.
No, within the time frame, of course, I know whether you give it in the time or not, how far you are going to fairly solve that one is a big question mark only. But I will prepare a question paper in such a way that even if you can copy, you will be caught. So that way, in that way, it will be there. So what I suggest to you is, plagiarism is not allowed at all. Please remember, try on your own. And whatever best you can deliver, you deliver it. So don't, even if you discuss with somebody else also, that points you will not be able to get it. So what I suggest you is, on Saturday afternoon, I will post the question paper.
This Saturday, sir?
Yeah.
Sir, this Saturday? Yeah.
I will just post the question paper. You submit it by Monday. Is it not okay?
Sir, you post on Monday and give time till Tuesday IT lab.
Okay, then fine. Okay, fine. Fine.
Yes, sir. No. Yeah, Monday. Saturday is post or Saturday. We can have Sunday whole day to work.
That's what I told. Saturday, I can post on Saturday. You will have Sunday time. But somebody is having Sunday problem. That is the thing, I think.
So like we will have time to...
Anyway, I will just post the question paper on Monday and you please submit it by Tuesday. 24 hours time I will give you.
So Monday, we will have classes. And so if you post on Saturday, it will be good. We'll do it.
Yeah. So this is the problem.
Minor on Sunday and.
Yeah, little bit scheduling problems are there. So what I suggest is, I will post the question on Tuesday, our regular class hour. Okay. So the 3 hours will be there. Not only 3 hours, you can take the another 21 hours, and you submit it by the Tuesday evening or Wednesday morning or Wednesday evening, whatever you like to have. Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
So you have time, our 3 hours time will be there anyway. Our class times are there. If you can submit it by 3 hours, it is well and good. If you cannot submit in 3 hours, you take your Tuesday evening time and you can do it, and you submit by Wednesday morning or afternoon. It is up to you.
So
that day it won't be any synchronous class.
Synchronous discussion is not having on that day.
Synchronous discussion, I will not discuss anything. Only you question paper, if you have any doubts, you can clarify with me.
Okay.
Only question paper discussion. Regarding the questions, whatever I gave you, if you have any doubts, you can ask me. Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
So please inform to all of your friends, that is the coming Tuesday, you will have your mid-examination question paper. So you will have 24 hours time to submit that answers.
Half of the fourth unit is included, sir, right?
Yes, yes.
Introduction to Ajax and jQuery.
Yes. Half of the fourth unit is there. Up to that. Plus introduction to Ajax, that's the only thing.
Okay, sir.
Anyway, I will post it here now. Just hold on. Can you see my screen? Are you able to see my screen?
Yes, sir.
So I'm posting on the course page itself.
Or sir, you can send us a mail like you sent in IoT.
Yes, I'm doing that one. I'll do that because first I will clarify with you, then only I'll fix it up. That's why I'm doing it now. Hold on. Is it okay? The topics also I mentioned here.
Okay.
Yeah, I have sent the mail to all the participants. Kindly check. I hope I am audible to you.
Yes, sir.
Yes, yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yeah, please check your inboxes. I have sent a mail to all of you.
Received, sir.
Yeah, yeah, fine. So if any mail is bounced, then I will get back. So far, I have not got any bounce back. So hopefully, students might have received it, but they have to check their inboxes. That is a problem. Any other queries, let me know. Otherwise, we'll wind up the session for today. Nagamani, yeah. So anyway, the session has been recorded. So the recorded session, you